Lord that upholds all things by the power of his word, we come before you today to do the city's business. We pause first to lift up the Burkett family, Father, and we ask you by your Holy Spirit to strengthen and comfort and give them peace in this time. And Lord, direct the mayor and the council in the city's business. Lead their steps. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Councilman, I need a motion on the work session minutes from the 4th of April.
Motion to approve.
A motion, all in favor, raise your hands.
Six with four abstaining.
Okay. Need a motion on the regular council minutes for the 4th of April.
Motion to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Six with four abstaining.
Very good. Mr. Mayor, you're up.
Thank you. It's already been acknowledged that David Burkett's mother, Bernice Walker Burkett, passed away, and we extend the deepest sympathy to you in that loss. Michael Burdell has a number of certificates for citywide championships, but David, I don't have them. And
I
so,
have.
Oh, you've got them. Oh,
I
well,
do.
Wonderful then. Would you like to join me here as we honor so many of these group young men and maybe some women? I'm not sure. Some of the groups that have been organized over the years, and they've competed mightily over the last few weeks.
Box.
They're in your box. All right. Why don't we do this? Would you go then to the next issue we got up there? I just got these hot off the press. Dawn Hathcock, would you stand up, take a bow, please? This is the Convention and Visitor Bureau. Literally, stand up, take a bow, because as you see, both for the month of March and year to date, you'll see that we are again atop the state in our hotel occupancy. For the month at 73.5, that 64 will get into the 70s as the summer months come. But if you look down below the occupancy for March, 82% downtown and 78% at East Chase in exit 6, 76%. That is extremely strong. And we keep holding our breath, but we know that the old skate park, there will be something started almost immediately there. The Bishop Parker, there's something starting there. All the plans have been approved. And also the old Hilltop Arms is under construction. And as soon as they can mobilize the contractors, that will be under construction. And we have probably two or maybe three others that we'll be announcing pretty quick. And so while those, it'll take us a year to get those on lines, Dawn's job will be to fill up these hotel rooms. We just continue to have opportunities, whether they be sports related or whether we be association related, to do that. So Dawn, congratulations, but what have you done for us lately? here comes David. David, why don't you join us? And what we're going to do is we're going to present some certificates to the coaches, and then we're going to ask all of those individuals that are associated with these certificates if they would come down and we'll get a picture. Okay? You want to do it? Huh? Well, I don't have them. You've got them. I know, but the coaches, how we want to do this. Why don't you talk about what these are? Tell everyone who, what the teams are and why you're doing this. How about that?
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Let me say it in English. Good afternoon, everybody.
Good
Good afternoon.
There you go. Okay, could I have the teams of the Boys and Girls Club come up? The City of Montgomery? Let's go. Come on, Montgomery All-Stars. All three age groups. Come out around this way. And coaches. Okay, these young men, ladies and gentlemen, participated in statewide tournament in basketball, and they finished number one and two number twos. They had outstanding records of 4-1, 5-0, and I think the other one was 3-1 en route to the championship. And they were the Cleveland Cavaliers of last year. They weren't supposed to win, but the end results, they won, and they are champions. Most of all, they are truly our community champions. So I would like to give everybody to give them a round of applause. Okay, I think most of them have had some transportation issues. Because what you looking at up there, it should be about 40 people.
About 10% of what's supposed to be
here. You're absolutely right. But these are the certificates, and this particular group, for their reward, they're in District 3, District 7, and District 4. That was combined of it. So it's not just one group coming out of District 4, they're from all over the City of Montgomery. So we just want to recognize them at this council meeting, and most of them wanted to meet the mayor. I don't know why, but most of them wanted to meet the mayor and just to shake his hand, and I think that's honorable enough. And mayor, can't thank you enough for accepting this on such a short notice of on this. But these young men also, council, I'm asking you with a begging eye. These young men also have a desire to go to Rocket Jump on Friday night. And I think Rocket Jump is something like $12 a kid. So I was just asking each council person, if you would donate $25 to this cause, you can. Some of you, Charlie Jenright, you can donate $250 if you want to. But again, let's give them a round of applause. We won't take up too much time. Come on now.
We actually had a presentation scheduled for today by Parks, not Parks, but Leisure Services, and because of some, we thought we were going to have 40 folks here, and because that the president and the mayor have an engagement at 6:30 tonight, we will defer Scott Miller's presentation until May the 2nd. He's got it prepared, but we're giving him a pass tonight, so that's what we have.
Very good,
and,
thank you,
and,
Mayor.
Mr. President, if the others happen to come in, they think they were supposed to be at 5:30. If you wouldn't mind, when another group comes in, if we could just get
stopping.
Yeah, we'll stop and get a picture if you'll do that.
That's good.
Good.
Okay. Very good. Okay. Okay. We have any special committee reports tonight? We have first item on the agenda tonight. Item number one, Madam Clerk.
Mr. President, item one, ordinance amending Chapter 12, Environment Sections 12-31 and 12-37 Code of City of Montgomery.
Mr. Lyons? Yeah, 30 days, okay. Item number two.
Item two, ordinance amending Chapter 11, Emergency Services, Ambulances.
Need a motion, gentlemen?
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Mr. President, I need to make two editorial changes on this one, if council will permit me to do that. The sites in 11-32C need to be changed and corrected.
Chair accepts that.
Okay.
Have a motion to approve. All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. The ordinance is adopted with editorial change. Item three, ordinance granting a franchise to Mobility LLC. Its successors are assigned to construct, operate, and maintain communication systems within corporate limits.
Need a motion to suspend the rules?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Need a motion?
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted.
Very good.
Item four, ordinance providing for a sales tax holiday on certain items during the third weekend of July.
Need a motion to suspend the rules?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Mayor, are we going to just leave it as is? Is that what we decided?
Yeah, I think so, but I think it'd be well to talk about the fact that this is not another sales tax holiday. It's moving the one that normally had been in the third week in August to the third weekend in July because schools are starting earlier. Just be aware of the fact that there are certain items. I'm sure the media will have this well publicized that what you can buy and get a sales tax break on it. We've had very good experience over the years since this has been done. As a matter of fact, if you'll remember, it was this city council that started a sales tax holiday before it went statewide. The only The only challenge was it was on everything. Yeah. And so what we found was a lot of the builders and other people that were buying supplies were buying their whole year's supply on that particular weekend. Mm-hmm. So it was good that the state restricted it only to school supplies. So that was good.
Okay.
Move to adopt.
And most adopt, all in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. Item five, ordinance consenting to disposal of certain real property by the Waterworks and Sanitary Sewer Board in Interstate Industrial Park.
Need a motion to suspend the rules?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
And motion to adopt.
Before we do the motion to adopt, could we ask Mr. Hannon?
Mr. Hannon, you want to talk about it?
Mr. Hannon, could you just come to the microphone, please, and just to give us some clarification as to what the transaction is about?
It's a little less than a 20-acre slot. They're going to build a warehouse over 200,000 square feet. It's a company that's an automotive company, high injection for door panels. It's a Korean company.
And 100 jobs?
100 jobs to start with, but they're going to build a 200,000 square foot building so they can expand into it and have more work.
Very good. Thank you, sir. Anything else? Any other questions? Need a motion to approve?
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. Item six, ordinance authorizing purchase sale agreement and sale of real estate for economic development at 414 Caroline Street.
This piece of property the city owns is slightly less than an acre. It's on 414 Caroline Street, directly across the street from the property that the city sold to Equal Justice Initiative. They'd like to purchase this $100,000, and their plans are to build a single-story commercial building about 8,000 square feet and have it completed at the very same time that they open up the Memorial for Peace and Justice, which will be about sometime in the fall of next year.
Very good. Need a motion to suspend the rules?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
Move to adopt. All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. Item seven, ordinance authorizing purchase sale agreement and sale of real estate at 144 Simpson Street.
Okay, I need a motion to suspend the rules.
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. Item 8, ordinance authorizing purchase sale agreement and sale of real estate at 541 and 545 Holcomb Street.
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
I believe, is Commissioner Sankey in the audience? I thought I saw him earlier.
He was earlier.
Did he walk out? Okay.
Okay. Need a motion to adopt?
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. 9, ordinance authorizing purchase sale agreement and sale of real estate at 644 Day Street, 631 Hamner Street, and 637 Mildred Street.
Need a motion to suspend the rules?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move for adoption.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. Item 10, ordinance authorizing purchase sale agreement and sale of real estate at 616 Stevens Street.
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. Item 11, ordinance authorizing purchase sale agreement and sale of real estate at 1514 Ferguson Street.
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Ordinance is adopted. Item 12, resolution authorizing agreements with the state of Alabama through the ALDOT for the Montgomery MPO for the purpose of continuous cooperative and comprehensive transportation planning process to include receiving federal and state funds for transportation purposes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes, sir. That was a mouthful. This is a resolution that basically updates the City of Montgomery's portion of about 11 resolutions from the Montgomery Metropolitan Planning Organization, changing from the previous transportation legislation, which is called MAP 21, to the FAST Act, which stands for Fixing America's Surface Transportation. And this is just to basically comply with the requirements.
I need a motion to suspend the rules.
Motion to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Motion to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted. Item 13, application for retail beer and retail table wine off premises only by Birmingham Highway Inc. doing business as Marathon Food Mart at 3150 Birmingham Highway.
Representative of Marathon Food Mart?
Yes, sir.
Your name for the record, sir?
Chris Hargett.
I'm Mr. Hargett. This is a public hearing. Anyone like to speak against this item, please come forward. Seeing none, if that public hearing has been held, it's proper for the council. Need a motion?
Mr. President.
Yes, sir.
Move for approval.
Have a motion to suspend the rules. All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted.
Good luck with the business, sir.
Thank you.
Item 14, application for a lounge retail liquor class 2 package license doing business as Petro Plus at 2244 West Fairview Avenue.
Your name for the record, sir?
Abu Kamal.
Yes, sir. This is a public hearing. Anyone like to speak against this item, please come forward. Seeing none, until the public hearing has been held, it's proper for the council. Need a motion?
Mr. President.
Yes, sir.
Move for approval.
Have a motion to suspend the rules. All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted.
Good luck with the business, sir.
Item 15, application for a nonprofit tax exempt license by Scott and Zelda Fitzgerald Museum, Inc., doing business as the Fitzgerald Museum Gala and Silent Auction at 300 Water Street.
Your name for the record?
Sarah Powell.
Sarah. You did a good job on television the other night.
Oh, thank you.
This is a public hearing. Anyone would like to speak against this item, please go forward. Seeing none, the public hearing has been held. Proper for the council. Need a motion?
Move to suspend the rules.
Have a motion to suspend the rules. All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted.
Good luck with your event.
Thank you.
Item 16, application for special events retail liquor license doing business as Lightning Line at 801 North Perry Street.
Representative Lightning Line here.
Your name Avery, Avery Ainsworth.
Avery, good to have you. This is a public hearing. Anyone would like to speak against this item, please come forward. Seeing none, if the public hearing has been held, it's proper for the council. Need a motion?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted.
Good luck with this event.
Thank you.
Mr. President,
Avery,
why don't you, we had some questions from the council about this event.
Okay.
So why don't you talk about Taca Libre?
So this is the second year we did Taco Libre. Last year, we held it in the train shed downtown. We had about 2,000 people show up to eat tacos, have craft beer from around the state, and also music. So a good, fun-filled afternoon in Montgomery. And this year, we're going to be moving it to the Western Rail train shed site, which Elsa J. Properties is getting ready for us to have it on, so that we could turn that into an event space to do special events. Same thing this year. You buy pesos. 5 pesos come with your ticket book. You use a peso to purchase a taco or a beverage. And we have 3 bands, a local band and 2 national touring bands. So we're going to really step it up this year and try to go bigger and better.
What kind of audience are you anticipating?
Oh, it's a wide range. Everything from kids and strollers to,
Numbers.
We're hoping 2,500 to 3,000 people this year. It's looking like the same trajectory as last year, and we were overwhelmed because we were not expecting 2,000 plus to show up. But we're ready for it this year.
Very good.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next item.
Item 17, resolution appointing Larry Peterson to the Montgomery Clean City Commission.
Mr. Bell?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted. Item 18, resolution appointing Michael Jackson to the Montgomery Clean City Commission.
Mr. Bell?
Move to suspend the rules.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Thank you,
resolution
Lord.
Resolution is adopted. Item 19, pursuant to Section 1153(1) Code of Alabama, authorization of demolition of an unsafe structure at 2 Davis Street.
Need a motion to uphold?
Move to uphold.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Item 20, authorization of demolition of an unsafe structure at 48 Davis Street.
Move to uphold.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. 21, authorization of demolition of an unsafe structure at 227 Marshall Street.
Move to uphold.
All in favor, raise your hand. Yes, sir.
Okay.
I'm supposed to be able to speak for that particular property.
I mean,
227 Marshall Street.
227 Marshall Street.
227 Marshall, that's my place.
Okay. I had prior conversation with him, so we don't carry that.
We'll carry that over?
Yeah, we can carry that over to more talks.
Okay, we'll carry it over 2 weeks.
Is this the property on Marshall Street?
Yes, it's one of them. First, let me introduce myself, y'all. My name is Oscar Borkin. I'm a construction person here in the Montgomery area. I rehabilitate several houses. On this particular property, we're being asked to do far over what it takes to make this a safe structure. If this structure is unsafe because of what particular reason, I think we should do whatever it takes to make it safe for the public. But when we're being asked to put carpet down in a house, to put brand new windows, a brand new roof, when that has nothing to do with it, I think it's unfair. I think what we should do is target whatever the situation is with the house. This house could have been repaired months ago. It could have been beautified in the neighborhood. It didn't have to continue to be in this situation. But when speaking to the people over the demolition department, they saying the only way I could start construction is that I write out a full plan that includes doing things that has nothing to do with this being a safe structure. It's unfair. It's unfair to me, the community, the city, and it's a waste of city funds. If y'all keep voting to tear down houses, that's $3,500 the city could keep when a person like me has the funds to do the necessary repairs, the necessary repairs. But when I'm being asked to do a bunch of things that has nothing to do with making this a safe structure, it's wrong. It's dead wrong. It's almost like the intent to just tear down houses in my community. For what reason? I don't know.
We have set rules of how houses, and we're not going past any rule. Mr. Carr, you want to address this for me, please?
Before you do, can I get some clarification if I want to vote on something? Can I just ask
you? Yeah, that's great.
Only thing I'm asking for is a
question. Mr. Bell has a question.
Yes.
I want to know that what I'm voting on is Mr. Burkett. Mr. Carr, is that we're here to vote on whether this is an unsafe structure or not. Am I clarified, am I correct on that?
No, sir, tonight, this is not an appeal. His appeal time is actually
No, my question is, are we voting on whether this is an unsafe structure? That's what we're voting on?
No, sir, you're voting to tear this house down tonight.
Okay, okay.
Are you the owner of the house, sir?
Yes, I'm the owner, but if y'all decide to tear it down, this is totally my point. You're gonna keep on voting to tear houses down as long as you make it impossible for people to fix the houses. And that's my problem today. My problem is that I'm being asked to do far more than what it takes to make it a safe structure. If I was told to make this a safe structure, 30 days, this place could be a safe structure and beautified. We could paint it and all. If you look at the house, you would see.
It has a roof on it.
Yes, it has a roof.
You ain't got a roof.
Well, the guy that had the house before me, he went there and he tore down the backside. And when I went to the city, I was told to remove that. We tore all of that on down, we moved it, it's cleaned up now. But during the visit, I don't know if it was this gentleman or not, but they telling me to do things that has nothing to do with it being safe.
Sir,
this place could have been fixed up 3 months ago.
Sir, what we do is ask you to come forth with a plan of action to make the house habitable in the end.
Okay.
And we'd be happy to work with you on that, but you have to come forth with a plan.
Yeah, as long as
the law requires.
Mr. Burkett has asked.
Sir, let's carry this over for 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
So we can have time to discuss this.
Okay.
Okay, so give Mr. Burkett, Mr. Burkett, we'll deal with Mr. Carter.
Yes.
All right.
And I'll be happy to speak with you.
Item 22.
Item 22.
To authorization of demolition of an unsafe structure at 608 Oak Street.
Move to suspend the rules.
Oppose. All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Motion to uphold.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Y'all did 2 votes on that one. We only needed one.
Sorry, we got you. We already moved to 24. You on 24 now?
No, sir. I'm just now fixing to read 23.
Okay. 23. All right.
Authorization of demolition of an unsafe structure at 623 Clinton Street.
Need a motion to uphold?
Move to uphold.
Okay. Motion to uphold. All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Item 24, authorization of demolition of an unsafe structure at 706 Carter Hill Road.
Mr. President, let me see if we have had some meeting of the minds with regard to this one, because Mr. Wilson, Attorney Wilson, is here. And I did ask that Mr. Carr speak with him before the meeting, and I don't know what they talked about. So,
We have an understanding.
Okay.
I was just concerned about the cost of demolition.
Yes, sir. And the understanding is?
Well, they're going to have to do estimates. It depends upon the size of the structure.
Yes.
To what the cost would be.
Yes.
And I was just trying to determine whether I could demolish the structure for less cost than the city was going to do it.
Yes.
And from what I understand, they solicit bids. And based on the bids they get, they allot those bids to the lowest bidder. So
yes.
What I'm gonna try to do in the next 2 weeks is see if I can get estimates that will be lower than the cost that it's gonna take the city to demolish. I have no objection to the structure being demolished. I'm just trying to just cost that.
Okay, we need a motion to uphold.
Thank you, sir. Right. Move to uphold.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. 25, authorization of demolition of an unsafe structure at 5944 Oakley Road.
Need a motion to uphold.
Move to uphold.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Item 26, resolution assessing the cost of abatement of unsafe structures on various lots.
Need a motion to suspend the rules on the remainder of the committee.
Move to suspend the rules on the remainder of the agenda.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous.
I need a motion on 26.
Motion to uphold.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted. Item 27, resolution declaring public nuisances, authorizing abatement, and assessing cost of abatement of public nuisances on various lots.
Motion to adopt.
Move to adopt.
All in favor, raise your hand.
Unanimous. Resolution is adopted.
Okay, Madam Clerk, do you have something else for us?
Before we do that, Mr. President, could we get the pictures of the young men that have come in?
Are they here now?
Can we do that?
Yeah, we can do that.
All of those that are here because of city championship, if you could come back again, get another picture with the mayor and the city council, and those that have come in a little bit later that didn't get your picture, if you could join us down front.
Let them come this way. Okay, come get your picture made. Champions. Thank you. Hang on, ma'am. I got one other thing before we go to you. Okay. Mr. Larkin, you have something you want to... Mr. Larkin?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. President.
I think that's different, that counts.
Mr. President, I'd like to recognize our circuit clerk of Montgomery County, the Honorable Tiffany McCord. And Circuit Clerk McCord is here today. And we were supposed to have a few more people as well, right? Ms. McCord?
Probably can't hear you.
Yes. Can you hear me? Yeah, you were supposed to have some more civically minded young people from Jack and Jill to be here today, and apparently they had some transportation issues as well. But Jack and Jill of America, in an effort to raise civically minded children who will contribute to their communities, the mothers and the students plan to be here with us today to witness the city council meeting. And I do believe we have one individual. Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yes. This is, yes. So thank you very much for, and I know as circuit clerk you realize the significance of and the importance of education, civics education for our children, and this is a great thing for Jack and Jill to be doing, and we appreciate you being here today.
Thank you, Tim. Okay, Madam Clerk?
Yes, sir, I have before you contingency funds for approval for District 7, $1,000 to McCoa, $1,000 to Southeast YMCA, and $500 to Britton YMCA.
Okay, anything else, gentlemen?
District 1.
District 1, okay. Yes, sir.
Madam Clerk, $500 to Clean City Commission, $250 to the Bad Boys Boxing.
To what?
The Bad Boys Boxing. $250 to Empower, the E.J. Johnson.
Alabama Empower.
Alabama.
Okay.
District 5. $500 to Alabama Empower and $500 to Bad Boys Boxing.
Okay.
District 2.
District 2.
Yes, sir.
$2,500 to Madison Park.
community reorganization.
Okay.
Okay, anybody else?
Mr. President?
Yes, sir.
$500 to T.S. Morris Youth Intervention.
Okay.
Got that one. Anybody else? I need a motion to...
Mr. Mayor, are you okay with these?
I'm okay with all of them.
Need a motion to adopt all this?
Okay. Motion to adopt.
Everybody raise your hand.
Unanimous.
Done.
Mr. President?
Yes, sir.
Before we go into public comments, I have a question, and I'm not a realtor, but in our demolition packets that we get, when we pull the title and who owns the house to send out the information, is there any way for us to tell how long that individual has owned the property before they get here?
Mr. Carr? How long, do you know how long these properties have been owned by the person that shows up to defend it?
When we get the packet and you give us all the information and you pull it and Arch Lee owns the house, can you tell how long Arch has owned that house when you pull it?
There should be an ownership page in there at the bottom, and it'll have the...
It's in our packet?
Yeah.
Yes, sir, it should be in the package with each one of them.
Where is it? Did you see it?
It may have a deed reference to it for when it was recorded.
Well, if you tell me it's in here, I believe you, but will you show me after?
He's going to show you. Go to 22. He's got 22 in his hand.
Okay.
No, sir. No.
Parcel information?
Ma'am?
You see it?
No.
Is this what you're looking for, Tom?
It is not in this package. We've been asked to kind of reduce the size of some of these for y'all.
This is page 20. This
but that doesn't give the length of ownership.
It says the deed date. That's when the date for the deed's filed.
That's a good point. Okay.
If you look at the...
Can I answer your question?
It still doesn't give a good reference of that.
Well,
if you want me to start including that...
I just want one thing that says when it goes, like, for example, when Mr. Boykin came. You know, if he just recently purchased this to renovate
it... I'll start including a page in there that has the ownership. It'll go back several years.
Okay.
And we'll make sure we get that in there for you.
Thank you.
Very good. Okay. In our communication, public communication roster for non-agenda items, Bobby Cleveland.